Today, we are going to learn about photography using two different types of cameras. But first, what is photography? Photography, as all of you know, is painting with light. Please write it down. It is painting with light. Now, how do you paint with light? Because light is everywhere. You know, all around you, there is light. Now, you have to record that light on a light-sensitive material. In the olden days, we had a camera which is the film camera. This is the one I was talking about, the film camera. Now, this camera records light which comes through the lens. This is the lens, which comes through the lens, and here there is a film on which the light is recorded. So, now we are in a different age, different time. We have another camera, which is known as the digital camera. And both of them come under the same category called SLR cameras, but the latest one is known as the DSLR camera. The one which I am holding now is the digital SLR camera. Now, the digital SLR camera doesn't have a film. It has a sensor on which the image is recorded. The lens is there, as in the film camera, but the recording is done on a sensor, which is light sensitive. And on the lens, you have the aperture which controls the light. As we told in the beginning, you are painting with light. So light is the raw material, and you have to control the light by this aperture, which will vary. If there is a place where there is a lot of light, then the aperture has to be reduced. If there is a place where there is less light, we have to open the aperture so that more amount of light will come into the camera's sensor. Now, let me just show you how this light falls on the film by opening this film camera. Now, this is the camera, as all of you can see. We can open it by just opening the box here. There is a kind of a door, and the film used to be in a cartridge. All of you may not have seen the film, but I'm just telling you the technology which we were using at that time. Now, this is the place where they put the cartridge, and one by one, the film moves to this place where it is exposed, and then it curls up in this place. This is the take-up spool, and this is the take-off spool. So, all the images will be recorded here. And we close this because light should not fall on the film. That is very important. No extra light comes into the camera. Only the light which passes through this lens falls on the film. That is very important. And there is also a mechanism to control the speed with which you take a picture or a photograph. You control it by using the shutter. Now, the shutter dial is here. In a similar manner, it is there in the digital camera also. We can control the shutter, but it is all electronics now. This is a mechanical camera because in those days, everything was mechanical. But now, it is all battery oriented. In the sense, if you don't have a battery, the camera stops. But in this camera, even if you don't have a battery or anything, it will work because it works in the principle of mechanism. So, this is the film camera, and now I will show you the digital camera. This is the digital camera, and all the information is recorded on the sensor. And just like in the film camera, we have the aperture on the lens, and as you all know, the lens can be removed, but first I have to switch off the camera because It's all electronics, and the electronics should not be spoiled. So I'll switch off this camera. There is an off on button here, and then I can remove the lens. The lens comes away from the camera. So we can put different kinds of lenses, because in photography we shoot different subjects. So depending on the subject we shoot, we can put the lens we want. Now this is a kit lens, and this lens has a focal length of 18 to 55 millimeter, 18 mm to 55 millimeter. And this is good enough for shooting something which is close as well as slightly far away. But if we have a subject which is very far, then we need to change this lens to a telephoto lens. Now, most of you would have seen a telephoto lens in different places, like in sports photography. If you have seen a sports photographer, he will be using a long lens, which is a telephoto lens. Or if you have been to a wedding, the candid photographer will be using a telephoto lens, which is white in color, and that is a lens which has got a focal length which is very high. That is about the lenses. And once you are fixed the lens, you will take the picture and then interchange the lens. So we have talked about the lens, and the shutter can be controlled in the menu, and the aperture also can be controlled in the menu. And you have a screen here which is called as the LED screen, which stands for light emitting diode screen, LED. And in those days it used to be an LCD screen, which was LCD, that stands for liquid crystal diode. So that was a different technology. But this screen consumes a lot of power of the battery. So it is very important that you see through the viewfinder. And to see through the viewfinder, you have to open the lens cap. This is known as the lens cap, which is in front of the lens, and you use it for protecting the lens so that dust and other external elements don't go inside. Okay, so you use it for protecting the lens. And there is a neck strap which you should wear around your neck so that the camera is always steadily held. Okay, if you happen to keep it somewhere, you know, it will fall down or anything. But here on the neck, it is very safe. And this part of the camera is known as the hot shoe, on which you attach a flash. This is a very important place because an external flash can be attached here. And this one is the viewfinder. When you see through the viewfinder, you see the image exactly as it will be recorded on the sensor. There is no change in the image. So whatever you see through the viewfinder will be recorded on the sensor. That is known as the VisWig. All of you know what is VisWig, don't you? What you see is what you get. So that is VisWig. What you see through the viewfinder is recorded on the sensor. So this is known as the DSLR, and it stands for digital. SLR stands for single lens reflex camera.